Well, basically creepiness comes from something positive being juxtaposed against a quite strongly negative factor, which takes the positive thing out of its proper element. For illustrative purpose, consider the following examples. In this example, the positive thing here is flirting and a giving compliment. In the left example, the man is healthy and courageous enough to carry out the compliment with charm. He's also clean in his appearance, fit, and hygienic, and so there are basically two balancing positives. The resulting effect is charming. In the right example, however, the man is visibly nervous and not particularly healthy either. He is not fit, and may have various health ailments. These are things which tarnish the charm of a human being, and hinder charisma from blossoming, and so this is a strongly negative factor, lack of overall fitness and hygiene, that juxtaposes against the positive, and so it creates a creepy effect. In this example, since the man is delivering a compliment, he needs to also be charming, because a compliment really needs to be paired with charm in order to maintain the basic functional unit of a human expression and interaction. If a compliment is delivered without charm and without health hygiene, then it will come across as creepy because the two forces juxtapose negatively against each other. Of course, this does not mean that people who aren't fit are doomed to never date, but there are other types of human expression which do not juxtapose negatively against being in poor fitness, such as a strong sense of humor. Edit: I want to also make it clear too that, handsome guys, can be creepy too, since a lot of people seem to be of the impression that this answer is pushing an unfair narrative. A handsome, gorgeous guy, can also be creepy if he flirts, which is positive, and yet he is completely an egomaniac, which is highly negative. In this case, being gorgeous will not help him and he will also appear creepy, because people will pick up the juxtaposition of flirting with his scummy narcissism. The whole element of creepiness is not about being gorgeous or ugly. Gorgeous people can be perceived as creepy too. Such as the crazy obsessed girlfriend meme. She is gorgeous, but if a gorgeous person is doing something strongly negative, then it juxtaposes, and so being pretty doesn't diminish the creep factor. I'm including this to make it clear how anyone can be creepy, since a lot of people seem to feel that I was unfairly pointing out ugly guys, which in the end may be a fair assessment anyway. With vampires it is the same principle. A vampire juxtaposes the normal, positive thing, a living human being, against a strongly negative factor, namely corpses and death and decay. So a vampire is creepy, because the positive thing, life, and being alive, is juxtaposed negatively against a strongly negative factor, that is to say death and being corpse-like. And the same is true about a creepy smile. If something is smiling, and yet the eyes reveal something negative going on within their psyche, then this will be seen as creepy because the positive thing, a smile, which is a friendly expression, is being juxtaposed strongly against a very negative thing, in this case, a predatory or unsettling stare. Many times, autistic people are considered creepy and it has to do with this principle. Since autists have a developmental disability, they lack intuition about when it is logical to look away and break eye contact. So if they aren't careful, they can stare for too long. And this is negative because staring at someone dead on is generally universally regarded as a bad sign and a behavior of hostility or bad intent. So if an autist is trying sincerely to socialize, which is positive, meanwhile they are staring too much, which is generally universally regarded as a negative, then it will be perceived as creepy and unsettling by their conversation partner. This principle applies to everything creepy, such as dolls. The positive, they are a toy, meant to bring joy to children. The juxtaposed negative, they are human-like but still lifeless, and do not blink. Notice, however, that teddy bears are not creepy. The reason why is because the positive being a toy, bringing a little joy, is not juxtaposed against any negative, because they look sufficiently unreal that it can't look unsettling or like a thing of unlife.